What's up everybody, it's Rowan from Radical Electric Bikes here with you again. Today we're doing a review of the Sidekick Trail V2 by Alter Ego E-Bikes. A big shout out to Kyle for giving this to me to review today in beautiful Stanley Park. It really turned out to be a nice day and I was really looking forward to doing this as a follow-up to the Sidekick Fat, which I reviewed a few weeks ago, which is basically a 4-inch tire version of this. And yeah, this is the 20 by 2.35 inch version, so it's not as fat. I mentioned in my last review of the Fat that some people may have a bit of an issue with how wide the tires are, and that's why they made this bike, is that it's more for the city rider in mind. You can still take it out onto the curbs and, you know, going off the trails and stuff, because they're really durable tires. They're, yeah, again, only 2.35s, but it's still just fine. They're not going to be having any problem handling mud, water, or anything coming up, because, well, you can outfit this bike with a bunch of accessories. It's completely naked right now, so it's a bit more of a naked review that we're going to be doing today. This is how it comes as is out of the box, Kyle told me. He just said this is how you would receive it. Pretty much nothing needs to be done to this when you do get it yourself, and it just comes out of the box that way. No assembly required. You don't even need to put on the front wheel. So it's good to go out of the box, just maybe some tuning of the brakes and just checking out the cables, making sure that they're all tight, and the seat height, handlebar height, things like that, and 1, 2, 3, you're good to go. This bike, I think it was at $16.99 Canadian, so it's really affordable. This is perfect for, again, people in the city, students, or anyone that does camping and likes to go RVing, because the fat tire, the tires again were a bit big, but this will fit even better than that one will, because you got such a slimmer profile and you can slide underneath things a lot easier or in your apartment. So yeah, going on, it's not super different from the Fat. It's pretty much all the same parts. It's the same iFOLD frame. This one comes in blue. It also comes in black, white, and red. And it's just an aluminum alloy frame, just like the last one, and folds up in just a few seconds. But the suspension, that's one of the other differences. This is the Mozo R120 adjustable suspension fork. It's a hydraulic lockout, so you can do that, which is a little bit extra for a folding bike, but that is what this one was. It's just a more kind of user-friendly bike. I'm not putting down the 4-inch balloon tires that the other model had, but this one gives you a little bit more feeling of the road. Like, you can detect bumps, just feel it a bit better, definitely more controllable. I did like the Fat for how you can just kind of tilt on the walls of how fat the tires were, but this one gives you a lot more connection with your ride. You feel a little bit more connected to the bike itself. This is a Samsung 48-volt 10.5-amp-hour up to 50-kilometer range battery with the iBMS Intelligent Battery Management System. And what it does is it prevents you from overcharging your battery as well as depleting it too much. This is the problem with lead acids, and that's why we don't have those anymore, is they would cause problems, and this prevents you from having any issues while you're riding. You can just quickly charge this up in about 1.5 to 2 hours, depending on the amperage of the charger that you're using. There are, I believe, two chargers available, which I'll just also note later on in this review, which ones those are. We're going to go over into their website, and we'll go over the accessories, like the fenders, some of the utility carrying racks. So here's Alter Ego Bike's website. This is the page for the Sidekick Trail V2 that I've left in the description of this video so you can easily navigate to it. But as we scroll down, this is where you'll see your color selection for matte white to super blue, matte red, and matte black. That's available for pre-order at the moment. The standard 2-amp charger comes with it, but if you want some faster charging, I would recommend the Rapid Charger. It's a 3-amp and comes with a cooling fan. It's $49, so that's great for those who are doing those long-range trips, like, more consistently, and great for those traveling. Like, if you want to have this always ready for you, I would recommend getting that. LED lighting, of course, I would get these. It comes with the rear as well, by the way. It just says headlight and not rear light, but it does come with both, so there's that. And the fenders, those were $89 for both. That's nice for the rain and winter times, or just having them on just regardless. It just keeps you a little bit tidier. And the racks, those were $178 for both, $89 each, because you might not need both. I personally would just have the rear. But if you're carrying a lot, like if you do a lot of like work on this bike, or if you have a business that you're even running, this is good for, you know, food couriers who are carrying food around consistently, and they need somewhere to put things down and like use their bike as a platform. But then the accessories, there's also the 12-volt car charger, handle bag, charger case, the pannier messenger bags,
folding bike locks, electronic horn, and handlebar mirrors. Now, these are all just extra add-ons, but I would recommend a few of these, like the horn and the mirrors, just for safety. I really think because they're just available, you might as well just grab them. For only $39 and $49 each, I mean, that's nothing, costs nothing in comparison to what it will be investing towards your safety. At nighttime, and even running them at daytime, I do recommend with the lights, because you know how some people driving are. They just apparently don't see anything. Another thing I wanted to mention about the frame is that it had two screws for a water bottle or putting the lock on there.
Again, that locking technique I love to mention is to just cable it up and basically tangle it so that it's unattractive to a thief to take. I mean, it's just good to do as much as you can if you're leaving your bike outside, especially in a nice boot like this. I love the color on this one. If we get a little bit closer, you can see it's got a pretty nice sheen to it. This is why I love these so much, is that a lot of delivery companies, if you're a Skip or Uber driver for a bicycle carriers, folding bikes are the best. Some people might disagree with me on that, but for getting around quickly and onto an elevator, this is why it's so great. You can actually fit it onto an elevator. Big thumbs up for that. Down to the motor, this is the 48 volt MXUS 500 watt motor, and brushless, nominal torque of 75 newton meters, so it really puts you up a hill. We're going to do a bit of hill riding going up, I think it was Robson, and you'll see me being flung up there like no issue. So going up to the ride modes, you have manual, and then depending on the level that you want it, you can kick it up from 1, 2, 3, 4 to 5, and your throttle is going to be right here just on the left. So your brakes, throttles, and all your controls are really accessible just with the thumb. It's very comfortable that way. So the bike has a waterproof rating of IP65. All the wiring is done very nicely, and on my previous review with the Fat, we didn't see the USB port mounted in the correct position, so that's it right here. If we just open that up, you'll just see that's where you'd plug in your accessories. So you can charge your phone, you can do a speaker, you can even mount the speaker right beside it, so that's awesome. So you don't need to have anything in a strange location. Like I said, with the handlebar and all the controls, it's all just there, so you can have your speaker here. The display is a Kuntang KT LCD7 display panel with your speedometer, odometer, trip meter, and again, the USB charging port. It uses the Shimano 7-speed rapid fire shifter on the 7-speed tourney system. Works very well with a reared hub, so it's just not more or less than you need. Some folding bikes, they go a little bit too high, but not this one. Just using a 14-tooth flywheel, or 14x24-tooth flywheel. Back in the rear and the front, they are they're Jack 160mm mechanical disc brakes. And they're pretty much all that you need for a folding bike like this. It's like the handlebars, it's all just aluminum, extra wide, and it can accommodate any riders up to, I think it was like 6'3". If we just up the handlebars a little more, it would be too high for me. So we got it all set up just right for me at least. And beauty of the folding bike is they are made for pretty much anybody, whether you're a child, not too small of course, but up the way up to the adult sizes. So very, very awesome. Can hold up to 300 pounds. Yeah, about the same as the Fat, so no difference between like the thickness of the tires and the thinness of these ones for weight capacity. They're CST all-terrain tires. They're the 20x2.35s. Puncture resistant, so they're lined a bit. These are alloy sport rims. They're spokeless. No maintenance is required for taking care of these. You don't need to tighten them or anything. Maybe just every once in a while as you're going over some bumpier terrain, if that's what you like doing with this bike, you might want to tighten maybe this and that, which it shouldn't come off anyways. Just something that I would keep an eye out for myself. And yeah, that's it for the spokes. Nothing too much to note about those. The Fat, that was like a 5-spoke or 5-finger. This one is 6, so it's got a bit of better weight distribution going around the whole wheel. They put it together nicely, and they have the battery in the best position possible. I personally don't like batteries that have them in the frame. They just kind of, they're a bit bulky, and it takes away from the whole small, portable look of the bike. That's a general wrap up of what the differences are between the Sidekick Fat and the Trail V2 here. We're just going to take it out for a test ride now here in Stanley Park and near the seawall, just to give you a quick idea of what it feels like. It's going to be tested just on the grass. We're going to take it out onto some gravel and near that duck pond that's just just a little bit off to our right here. And take it more for a kind of forest adventure, since we're so lucky here in Vancouver to have so many beautiful trees and nature to explore. So without further ado, let's take the Sidekick Trail V2 out for the test ride. Okay, so we've got the bike put onto the first speed setting. We're just gonna start taking off here in this parking lot and make our way through Stanley Park. We'll just make our way past this lovely couple and make sure we don't hit those guys. And now we're on our way into the park. We're just on speed level one, and I know that you can't really see the display setting very well right now, but it's really easy to read. Even in the sun, the glare is not that bad. It's just a nicely made display, and it does help a lot. So once the traffic goes down a little, we're gonna make a crossing and get into the park here. So first thing I should mention is just while I was slowing down there, the brakes felt nice and tight, and we'll just let our friend go there. All right. Yeah, you'll be seeing me do that as we go down some more hills, like right down here. We're just gonna actually follow these cars and keep clear of the bike path, because there's been a lot of people like, oh, just like that guy just jumps off the board out of nowhere. So you just want to keep an eye out for that. Yeah, so the brakes will work when you need them to. The levers are like kind of oversized. They're almost like motorcycles, so they wrap all the way up to the pinky on my hand. I got pretty large hands, and it's very comfortable. So if I just give it a nice little squeeze here, oh yeah, let's slow it right down. So you can see it's a very busy day. We're just gonna go around here, just taking our time, making sure everyone gets around safely here. Go through. Okay, so I'm gonna take it out into the grass, give you a taste of what the tires feel like. So right away, yeah, I can feel the ground a lot more. This is nothing like the Sidekick Cat, where those balloon tires, as you can tell in the sound of my voice, is it's not absorbing too much, except for with the front suspension, which does do some work, but it is a very different feeling from the balloon tires. We're just gonna take a left here and go a little bit off road. There's a bridge over here that I like to go over, but I have to be careful this time, because I remember there's a little goose family, and they were just waiting for me at the bottom. Oh, there's a little bit of mud there. We're just gonna use the throttle to get us up this part of the bridge here. Oh yeah, it's so torquey. That just pushed me right over as if it was nothing. Okay, so we've made it to the lake, and this is a perfect little straightaway here. I can show you the speed capabilities of the bike. I've been keeping it at the 7th speed, just because it's so comfortable, even just on the first setting. You can get up most hills and get around all those little canyons with really almost no issues. We're in the city, of course, so for example, if I just take it to the left, which we'll do once these guys pass here, just go a little bit off-road. Yeah, you can feel the difference right away. Okay, so I've got it down to the first gear on speed setting one, and it just is barely detectable. You're going so low that you can't actually feel too much of a difference, especially if you're rolling a little bit. So I'm just going to tap it up to about four there, and yeah, now I can feel the motor pulling just a little bit more smoothly. Now, we are just on this trail here. We're going slower just to feel out exactly where the motor is going to be grabbing. And all these nice people are moving over, and they can hear me talking. So as long as you keep an eye out, everything should be okay. So it's pretty good on PAS level one. We're going to turn it up to two, and we're still on the fourth gear. And yeah, it's just pulling pretty hard. You only need to put it up to the fifth one, because it's going to max it out to 32 kilometers anyways. But it has that torque to get you right up those hills. Now, we will ride out of the park and turn around in just a few moments here, just after we finish exploring the park and going along with the trail on the Trail V2. As I mentioned before, Alterego has been making folding bikes pretty much exclusively since mid-2014, and this is their latest V2 model. I would have to say it's probably the most pleasant to look at, and also smooth with the suspension type of bike. This is perfect for anybody that wants something affordable. It's economical. Okay, so we pulled over just for a moment just to show you from a standstill what the throttle can do. I am just on this part of the trail here, so I'm going to be careful as I'm going around the corners. But just from a standstill here, we're at zero, and now we're just going to take off. And this is exclusively using the throttle. Yeah, I can feel how the gravel, if you go a little too fast, these tires would maybe roll a bit, but as long as you're under control, oh, the throttle is great. It's very responsive. You just push down and it just takes you off.
Now, with 500 watts and the 75 meters of torque, 8 meters of torque, it's gonna haul you, and if you wanted, anything you're carrying, it's not gonna have a hard foot either. The range might be affected, but that torque and all that power is still gonna be there whenever you need it. Okay, so now we've got a better straightaway here. I'm gonna give it more throttle, and once we're over the hill, you'll be able to see more on level ground how it's gonna be performing. Oh yeah, so once you're over that hill, it just starts to clear you right across any straightaway. We're at about 32 kilometers an hour now, and on a folding bike like this, it feels like you're going a whole lot faster. Yeah, this is great for taking out onto like a little track, doing some racing with your friends. Oh man, like I can just see everybody loving this bike as much as I love it, if not more. All right, so you can see on the grass, it performs pretty well. It grips the grass, it doesn't slip, as long as you're not taking too hard of a turn, that is. Just gonna keep maneuvering around all of our friends here. And some more, go back out. There we go. I'm taking us over to Robson Street, where there's gonna be a really nice hill that's going all the way up from the bottom here down at Denman. So you gotta keep an eye out for those pedestrians, dude. And we're just gonna show you how well it climbs the hill. This is a pretty steep one, and the traffic's not too bad, so it looks like we can just keep rolling up and then just come all the way back down. So we're gonna boot it right up to level 3. Had it on 2 for the last little while. And we're just gonna let this carry us. Like, I'm just pedaling my legs very, very lightly. I'm not even trying to push down, and it's like the motor can just detect exactly when I'm pushing it. So it's just lifting me up. I don't even need to turn this up to the 4th or 5th setting, but we will just for demonstrations purposes. Okay, so taking off again, we're just going to keep it up on 5. Yeah, I'm actually pacing it with this Hyundai right now, and I'm not even trying to do that on purpose, I'm just pedaling it. So this is a pretty decent grade of a hill, and to be honest, this is no sweat. I am not breaking a single sweat. It feels almost too good. If we just take it off of the pedal, let's just keep it on the throttle now. Oh, that felt so smooth how it just transitioned from me pedaling. Oh, we're just gonna take a sudden right here. Yep, we're going right now. To the right, to the right, to the right, to the right. Okay, so you're able to just see there how well it climbs the hills. I'm just having a blast riding this. I have been using mostly the pedal power, and it's really fun and kind of addictive, to say the least, actually, just feeling it take off from beneath you like that. So yeah, it's just, you get to have the feeling of a motorcycle with no license or anything like that if you just want to use the throttle, which we'll just switch over to now. And we're just bursting out of the gates. Nice. So we're just gonna go over a couple curbs here. I just love taking this out onto a trail. Like, it just has all the capabilities of a trail bike, just with no rear suspension. So if that's a must for you, then it might not be perfect fit for you then, but the front, I love it. It feels really smooth. And now we're just back here at the parking lot where we started, where, oh yeah, we can just take it for a nice little run. Oh wow. Yeah, got it topped out, 32 there. But I'm telling you, when you're on a bike that feels like this, like a folding bike, you feel like you're going a lot faster. I would recommend to go to Abbotsford instead and talk with Kyle, because he's really awesome. He was the one that brought the bike out to me today, and it's just a blast to be able to review such fun bikes like this one. So that is pretty much it for the Sidekick Trail V2. Had a real lot of fun riding this around everywhere. As you can tell, we put a little bit of mud just onto the tires there. We took it around for quite the run. And if we look at the battery level, I'm not sure if you can see it because the LCD and the reflection of the screen, but we lost a little more power, just at about 30.1 kilometers. So yeah, that's over half of its distance. Its range capabilities are good at the high levels. They don't have to be always low. That is just, of course, if you're going for longer range. Big shout out to Kyle again. Thank you for letting me review the Sidekick Trail V2. Again, they're based in Abbotsford, BC. You can go get yours in store or order it online. I will be leaving links in the description below where you can click those, where you can suit it up with all the accessories that you like. And if you do absolutely need the balloon tires, the Sidekick Fat is available. It felt pretty much identical to the Sidekick Fat, except lower profile tires. I could feel the road a little bit better. Power, speed, all that is the same. Same with the range, of course.
And there's even an electric horn that you can add. So if you really want to soup this all up, you know, it'll increase the price a little bit. But this bike standalone was $16.99 when you buy it online or in their new store at Abbotsford. So just go in person and say hi to Kyle and go for a test ride if you like. I highly recommend it. So again, thank you. This is Rowan from Radical Electric Bikes. Really, really excited to get to do this review today. It was pretty anticipated because it was in follow-up to the Fat, Sidekick Fat. So again, thanks for watching. This is Rowan signing off, and stay tuned for the next Radical review. Take care.